Today is all about rendering files in Final Cut Pro. Let's go.
You can change your background rendering options by going to your Final Cut Pro preferences. Navigate to Final Cut Pro and choose Preferences, or use the shortcut Command Comma. In the Preferences window, choose the Playback tab. You might have background rendering turned on, which automatically renders your clips after a set amount of time. When dealing with more advanced graphics, you may want to consider turning background rendering off to minimize any slowdowns while editing. And when needed, we can manually render our clips to preview them in high quality. But you can adjust these preferences to whatever suits your editing workflow. With background rendering turned off, you may notice a dotted line at the top of the timeline. This indicates which parts of our project have not been rendered. So if we play back our project, the unrendered video may play at a lower quality. Rendering our project or specific clips will basically create temporary media files so that Final Cut Pro can play them back at higher quality. Let's render some clips. We'll start by selecting the clips we'd like to render. Navigate up to the top menu and choose Modify. We can choose to render only our selected clips with the shortcut Control R, or render the entire project by using the shortcut Control Shift R. We'll use the shortcut Control R to render just the clips we've selected. As the project renders, the dotted line will disappear, indicating that that portion has been rendered. You'll also see this progress wheel in the upper left corner. That shows you how much your project has remaining to render. You can click on it to open the Background Tasks window, where you can view and manage your background tasks in more detail. Once your render is complete, you will no longer see a dotted line on the timeline, and the wheel at the top left will be highlighted blue with a check mark. Now, if we play back our project, it will play at full quality, representing how our final project will look. Keep in mind, having a lot of render files can take up quite a bit of storage space, which might hinder performance. Be sure to check out our video converting how to manage your render files, linked in the description below. Now you know background rendering is a choice. There's a reason to and a reason not to. There is no longer a question. Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level. Hello. Have you been looking for free tutorials for Final Cut Pro? Look no further! Pixel Film Studios provides! Like, share, comment, spread the word. Thank you.